friend who lives in New England. I don't know why I'm telling you, I do know why I'm telling you this. I'm going to tell you this because I'm here in Zogo and I've been here often before. Anyway, this friend of mine, I don't know how this story will sit with those of you who speak English and can understand it, but I really like it. This friend of mine, who's now about 100 years old, came here in 1951 on a honeymoon, and he drove down from Klagenfurt or wherever it is in Austria. Right, it's Klagenfurt. I've done it myself a number of times. I know exactly what the road is. They didn't have a very good map and they thought they were lost, so they kept asking people if they were on the road to Zagreb. See, and most people looked at them and didn't. There was a guy standing by the side of the road. He had a moustache and everything. And they pulled up and he spoke English. And they asked him if this was the road to Zagreb. It was, of course, at the time it was Yugoslavia. And he replied, "There is only one road in Yugoslavia." That's not quite the end of the story. So they drove on and eventually they went down to, and found their way to Greece. And in 1951, the road was not finished. I travelled that road for the first time in 1960-61, and it wasn't really finished then. Anyway, to finish the story, blah, 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 time goes by. And he splits up with this woman who's married, and time goes by. Eventually, she gets cancer. He hears about it, goes and stays with her for a bit, and then she dies. And at the end of his beautiful, beautiful short story, he finishes the short story with the line, "There is only one road," which is deeply moving, I believe. But what we should remember is, there is only one road, and we only get to travel it once.